So in the previous class, we were seeing about the life of Rousseau, how the Rousseau grown up, what was the situation in his time, and about his writing we have been discussing. The writing, one of the writing, which is titled as Emile. Okay, actually Emile is written with a focus on education, wherein there are two characters. One is the Emile itself. Emile is a male child, and there is another character which is known as a Sophie. Sophie is a female child. Okay, so by keeping in this context, Emile is written, and Emile only we have discussed because that is talking about the education, the educational ideas, educational thought, and a philosophy of Rousseau. Okay, but in general, when we talk about the educational philosophy, because in by discussing about the Emile and by discussing about the life sketch of Rousseau, a little bit about the philosophical orientation of Rousseau about education we have seen. But in detail, when we see the philosophical thought of Rousseau, educational thought, educational philosophical thought, when we see, we find that the philosophical thought of Rousseau was against the revolt of the autocratic and the artificial society. He was not attracted towards the autocratic and the artificial society. He was a person who was a great lover of nature, and he was in opinion that in the nature only the child can grow naturally to build his physic and the intellectual capacity. So whatever the thought, whatever the philosophy which we see, even the educational philosophy, even the political philosophy, even the sociological philosophy, whatever we are seeing about the Rousseau, is actually the revolt against the artificial and autocratic society. And that's why he advocates that the idea that should be a natural state, a natural man, and a natural civilization. These three idea he advocates. Natural state means the governance, the political system must be working towards the preserving the nature and allowing the civilians to grow as per the natural instinct. So there should be not force that what you want to do, how you want to live, that should not be imposed. There should be not much strict rules and regulations. There should be no scope of punishment and a reward even. Very interestingly, he used to talk that there should be no punishment, that we can understand. But even he talks about that there should be no reward also. And the citizen and the child must be allowed to grow as per the nature. And when you will see the book Emile, if you get a time, then you must read the book Emile. The full text of the Emile is available in the internet. You can search and you can download, you can read. It is a very interesting document. And he talks that let the nature will mold the behavior of a child. The governance and state should not mold the behavior. And interestingly, he talks one incident that if some child is breaking the window, right? We know that in the childhood time, the some children are very notorious and they are of a free mind. So if the child is breaking the window, they should not be punished, because usually we used to punish the child when they are breaking a rule or something undesirable they are doing. So he was in opinion that when the child is breaking the window, not to punish the child, let the nature will punish. How the nature will punish? Allow the child to stay in that room with the broken window. And when the child will be suffering due to the cold, due to the rain, because in the rainy season, rain may come inside the room. Then they will learn and realize. So let the nature will punish and let the nature will reward. And that's why he is against of these two things. There should be no punishment and there should be no reward. And he used to say that when the child will do a good thing, then the child will feel pleasure. And when the child will do undesirable thing, then the child will feel pain. And that will mold the nature of the child. That will mold the behavior of the child. So there should be no scope and the place of hard rules. Natural man, the man who is acting and believing in the nature as per the natural rules and the natural civilization. Let the civilization grow naturally in the lap of a nature. So there is a no place of artificial things in the philosophy of Rousseau. He actually says the cities, because when we talk about the civilization, in the name of a civilization, we have built cities of a concrete. And this type of a city where the artificial and unnatural things are prevailing, he is saying that the cities are like a grave. And you understand the meaning of a grave, I think so. So cities are like a grave. So he was hating that type of a situation and cities. And he was also, when we talk about the another book written by the Rousseau, that is The Social Contract. In The Social Contract, he writes, man is born free, but everywhere he is in the chain of a rule, the chain of a societal norms, the chain of a practices, the chain of a beliefs, and man himself is a responsible for the pain and sorrow. You can link it with the philosophy of a Buddha. Buddha also says that there is a pain and there is a cause of a pain and there is a remedy of the pain also. When we talk about the pain, which is defined in terms of Rousseau says that man is itself responsible for the pain and sorrow. Because man is not living as per the natural law. Man is not growing as per the nature. They are going away from the nature, and that is the cause of a pain and law, a pain and sorrow. And if the person will live in the nature, then the pain and a sorrow can be minimized. He also talks that the child is the essentially good. There is nothing wrong with the child. Child is a good. But his context with the society makes him bad. The context, the situation where the child is living, that is the responsible for the bad practices that is the child is developing. If the child will be in the nature, then this type of a thing will not be developed. So in this context, Rousseau argues that human must give up the present artificial society. The cities, the artificial cities, the cities of concrete, they should give up and go back to the nature for the reforming a natural man, a natural state and a natural civilization in order to get the happiness. This is the way to get the happiness, if they will go towards the nature. Because the child, when they take birth, they are not bad. They are good. They are pure in terms of Rousseau. And this is the society which makes the child bad. So what is the remedy? We must go in the lap of our nature. We must grow as per the natural law. And there should be no force for doing some work. And he was the person, when we talk about the nature and the freedom and all those things, he was the person who has given the concept of a liberty, equality and a fraternity. As per the natural law, not these three terms he has defined from the governance perspective. He is trying to define these terms from the governance of a nature. Okay, and that's why he has revolted, he was against the traditional education system. Because in the traditional education system, there was a scope of molding the behavior of the child as per the predefined criteria. There was a scope of punishment and a reward. And the education system that time prevailing, even now, it is taking the student away from the nature. But the Rousseau was the naturalistic philosopher who was believing that the nature is itself a rich in itself, which can mold the behavior of the child, which can make the student to learn, which can allow the child to learn. So nature is a great place for learning. And that's why the philosophy of Rousseau was a revolt against the education system, that was traditional education system prevailing at that time. And he is raising the voice to free the child from the strict discipline and artificial school environment and stereotype method of teaching. So from these philosophical point, you can understand that he was in opinion of destroying the stereotype method of a teaching and the very artificial and a concrete school building and premises. And when you will go further, you will find that he was in opinion that a child can learn better when they will interact with the nature, when they will observe the phenomena, when they will have a hands-on experience about the phenomena. Because in the nature, the child is free and the child is allowed to observe the natural phenomena that is happening. And then the child can learn by observing. And you can understand that how pedagogically sound is this philosophy. Because still we used to talk about the learning by doing, learning by observing, learning by hands-on experiences. So we talk by providing observing and the hands-on experiences in the restricted environment. Whereas when we talk about the Rousseau is not talking about the experiments or the observation in the restricted environment. Rather than he talks about the environment should be a natural, where the child must be allowed to see the things. Isn't it? So in that way, you can understand how his philosophical thought was a progressive in nature. Further, he says the state of a time, extremely varied examples of a life, and his impulses and the environmental nature, which will influence the child and shape the thought of the child. Because he accepts that whatever the thought the Rousseau is having, it is being shaped by the influence of the environment, impulse of the emotions, state of the time, and the various experience the Rousseau was having. Because we know that Rousseau was having a various kind of experience because he was wandering from one place to another place. In his childhood time, his father was a poor tutor and a watch repairer. So he was not having a sufficient financial resource for education and spending his livelihood. So he was wandering here and there, he was roaming here and there, he was interacting with so many people, and he has developed the thought that he was having. Okay, so that is the way he was saved. And we know that the Rousseau was a naturalistic philosopher, and he was thinking that nature itself is a good resource for all kind of learning and shaping the human. And he thinks nature in a three way. The first way is the nature as an endowment. Nature in as an endowment means the nature itself have a so many innate potential. And if the nature is having the innate potential, then the nature is itself capable of shaping the human, making them learn, making them understand, and the nature will give a lots of resources for their livelihood as well. And he says that education comes to us from the nature, because the nature is a sound resource. And he was in the belief that the best learning can take place when the child is free to develop and grow according to the natural impulses. We are not supposed to bound the child to do and perform and learn the predefined thing. What we are doing now, that we are forcing a child. And this force becomes extremely pathetic for a child when we try to impose our thought on the child. I have met several person, and I ask that why you have pursued even B.Ed. Then they are saying, no sir, in my family all are teacher, and my father is also teacher, my mother is also teacher, that's why I am pursuing B.Ed, so that I will also become a teacher, because my father suggested to be a teacher. I have seen so many doctors also, that their father said that pursue MBBS course, even in the engineering. That is the against the philosophy of Rousseau, and he was not in opinion of that. Let the child develop its own interest, and the child must be allowed to learn what he thinks is better for them. That is the natural impulses. He also treat nature as an isolation from the society. Nature as a mean for isolating the person from the society. And in response to that, Rousseau argues that nature is a good and everything, but the society is a negative which drags the child away from the nature. That's why the society, the child must be isolated from the society. He also argued in this context that the child should be saved and isolated from the evil society, and child should be brought up in the lap of nature so that they can develop their interest, their ability, their skills, their learning as per the impulse of nature. And the third thing he used to say about the nature, the concept of nature, is the natural phenomena. And he says that the living according to the nature and education in the natural environment and the life as per the nature, these can be a rich resources, and one can become a natural man automatically when he will be brought up and taught in the natural environment. So there is nothing to do to make a natural man. And that's why when you will see the educational practices of the naturalistic philosophers, like that when we talk about the Rabindranath Tagore, he is a naturalistic philosopher, he was a naturalistic philosopher. And when you will see the educational experiment of the Rabindranath Tagore in the Shantiniketan, Vishwa Bharati Shantiniketan, you will find that the child is allowed to learn in the lap of nature under the tree. There is no defined boundary of a classroom. There is no defined boundary of the school. However, due to the inference, because in that campus there is so many things, So that is the marked area. But still, the classes are being held under the tree. Even when we talk about the Mahatma Gandhi, he was also a naturalistic philosopher. So you will see that Gandhiji was also saying that the education must be as per the interest of the child. We should not impose. Even when we see the Gopabandhu Das, whose Bana Vidyalaya was one of his experiment in the Sakhi Gopal of the Odisha in the Puri district, and it is said that the Gopabandhu Das was so much influenced by the Rabindranath Tagore. But in fact, they all are philosophers from the naturalistic philosophy. Those who believe that the child, the person can learn better in the lap of a nature, and that there should be a natural surrounding, and the child must be allowed to learn as per their own interest. Isn't it? Even when we talk about the Rousseau, according to the Rousseau, the education is, it must be, the education must be according to the nature of a child. Child should be the center of gravity in the educational process. And the nature of a child should decide the nature of teaching. It is not the teacher who will decide what will be taught and how it will be taught and what kind of a learning outcome will be there. It is the child who will decide what should be taught. What should be taught means what is the interest of a child. It is the nature of a child which will decide that how it should be taught as per the interest of a child. It is the nature of a child who will decide how it will be evaluated, assessed. And when we talk about even the constructivism, it is also saying that the teaching, the content, the assessment must be by keeping child in the center. Further, when we talk about the Rousseau, further, the Rousseau says that there is a different stages of a child in his life. And the teaching learning should be as per the stage of a child. And that's why, as earlier I was talking about his book Email. So in Email, he has talked about the four stages of the child's life. And the total book Email is divided into the five parts. The part one is the education for infancy stage, that is the 0 to 5. Second is the childhood stage, that is the 5 to 12. Third is the adolescent stage, that is the 12 to 15. And the next one is the youth stage, which is 15 to 18 or a 20. And in this, he says that at every stage, the child life has its own way of seeing, thinking and feeling. And that's why the teaching at a different stage must be contextual. And that's why he talks about the contextualization of a curriculum, method of teaching, method of assessment as per the child's stage. And he talks that education from the nature, man and thing, that already we have discussed. And according to the Rousseau, education of a child comes from the nature, that is the physical environment, man, that is the relationship between the social environment, and the things, that is the acquisition of on experiences. Because the child is interacting with the so many things and the child is getting experience. So the child can learn from their own experiences as well. And in this whole educational process, a teacher must be as a guide who will be guiding the student, who will not be deciding the educational content, methodology, and the assessment plan. No, they will be guiding only. And that's why in this context, Rousseau talks about the negative education. Because he thinks that the society is a place where the child is becoming bad. So during the time of 5 to 12 years, because as per the Rousseau, birth to up to the age of a 12 year is a very crucial, where in the child is very easily attracted towards the bad habit and the negativity of the society. So what is the way to come out? We should take away the child from the society so that the child will not learn all those things, and we will take the child to the nature. So the child will develop their physical and intellectual capability with the impulse of nature. So in this context, the negative education is not a prescriptive one. Actually, it is a method of restricting the child from getting influenced by the society. That is the negative education. We had already discussed negative education in detail in the previous class. Okay, so that was how the Rousseau see the education in his own way. The next thing is that when we talk about the Rousseau's concept and aim of education, what was the concept and aim of education as per the Rousseau's philosophy? In the opinion of Rousseau, educational view of Rousseau were very much new at that time. It was a modern and it was a progressive, because that type of educational thought was not prevailing at during that time. And I have told that the thought and a philosophy of Rousseau is actually the revolt against the artificial society. So it was a new, and they are meant to relieve the child from the strict discipline, artificial school, social environment, and the so much of a control and a rigid method of teaching. The educational thought, philosophy, and the practices of the Rousseau was against the strict discipline, artificial school, social environment, and all those things. It was against that. The education, he was in the opinion of Rousseau, the education should aim at the fullest development of the child and development of the innate potentiality and the power in the natural environment. So rather than imposing our own thought, our own content, on our own method of teaching, they must be allowed to develop at their full potentiality in the lap of nature. That was the philosophy of, that was the thinking of Rousseau. And in this context, Rousseau defines education as it is a process of development. As in terms of Rousseau, it is the Rousseau's word. He says that education is a process of development into an enjoyable, rational, harmoniously, and a balanced, useful, and hence the natural life. The education is a process of development. See, here education is not defining that you are supposed to inculcate something. You have to teach some moral values. No, he is not talking about that. Moral values will be automatically developed. Social values will automatically develop when the child will be interacting with the nature. And that's why he says that education is a process of development of the innate potential of the child to the fullest, in a balanced way, in the enjoyable way, in the harmonious way, in the natural life. And in this context, he had a aim of education also. As per the Rousseau, the aim of education is to help the child to remain alive. It is also a very interesting point. He is saying the aim of education should be to remain the child alive. Remain the child alive means the original thinking, original interest, that must be nurtured and that must be preserved, rather than the imposing unnatural. Unnatural means our thought, our interest on the child. If we are imposing our interest, our thought, and if we are molding their behavior as per our need, then the original child in the person will die. And he says that education must be focused to preserve the original child, not to make them allow to die. And that's why, in terms of Rousseau says that life is not merely the taking of a breath, but it is an act and how to make use of the organs, senses, faculties, which gives us the feeling of our existence. So life is not merely taking breath. We used to think life is means we are living, taking breath and exhaling breath, that is a life. But in the terms of Rousseau, life is to make use of our organs, that is the physical body, make use of our senses, that is the intellectual and emotionals, and a faculty, which is the intellectual, to give us a feeling of your existence, that you exist, that you are there. That is the life. Means that when your original thought, when your originality is preserved, then you can understand that you are a living. And that's why he says that life is to live, to work, to develop, and to properly utilize the various part of the body, the senses, the organs, and the other power of the body, to realize as the real human being. And it is also again very interesting to understand the context in which he says that the real human being. Because in the present context, when you will see that when we are imposing our thought and our will on the child is no more the human being, because it start acting as a robot, that the non-living object, because their own innate potential is ignored. So if you are not able to think, do, act in your way, then how you will think that you are a living? You are obeying the other's order. So he says that is the artificial. That should not be a role of and the aim of education in general. But in particular, he talks about three things. That is the body, sense, and the faculty. That's why he stresses on the physical development, that the education must be focused toward the physical development. Because the Rousseau recognized in the feeble body, a feeble mind can exist. We used to say that in the sound body, in the healthy body, the healthy mind can be there. So that's why he stresses on the physical development. He stresses on the senses, that is the emotional development of the child. He also talks about the development of the innate faculty in the natural way, that is the intellectual development of the person, isn't it? So his education is focused towards the development of all the things, the body, the mind, and the emotional part. And when we leave these things with the Bloom taxonomy, we know that Bloom has also categorized the learning in the three taxonomy, that is the cognitive, affective, and the psychomotor. Cognitive you can understand with the intellectual, affective is the emotion, psychomotor is the physical development. So these all things are aligned with the recent development in the education. He also emphasized the learning of a trade, because he says that the education must prepare the child for the life. And how we can prepare the child for the life? By allowing them, by enabling them to earn their own livelihood. If the child is not able to earn their livelihood, then we cannot say that we are preparing the child for the life. Okay, we cannot say. Okay, and ultimately, last he also talks about that education must be focused towards, aimed towards development of a moral and a social values. But remember, the moral and a social values will not be developed when there will be a strict regulations. He says that child can develop the morality and a social values with the nature. So that is the aim of education as per the Rousseau. However, the Rousseau had the aim of education as per the different stages of life also, the different stages of child, because when we talk about the Emile, the work of Emile of Rousseau, he categorized four steps, and there is a five parts in the Emile. The fifth part is the girl education, that we will be also talking about. So he says that the education must be the stage specific. The first stage was that the infancy, which is 0 to 5, and here he talks about, in this stage we must provide the infant child full freedom to enjoy and engage and exercise in the natural surroundings, so that their body will grow. And we know that this is the age of development of a motor skills and a fine motor skills, where the child learns to control the body. Child learns to learn, because for a learning there is also some basics of a learning, like that the fine motor skill. Without the having a fine motor skill, you cannot write. You must learn the some basic vocabulary in order to communicate. So here this is the stage when the child learns to learn, isn't it? And that's why the child must be given a full freedom, no restriction. In the second stage, the childhood, which is from 5 to 12 years. He says that in this stage, the child develops the sense organ through the experience and observation. Here the child can be engaged in the various observation activities and experience the various thing in the nature to develop his sense organ. Then the adolescent stage is 12 to 15 years, and here he says that in this stage the adolescent develop their personality through the hard work, guidance, and the study of the various subjects. In this stage, the child can be taught the different type of a subject, like a geography, mathematics, science, and this type of a subject can be taught. And last, that is the 15 to 18 or 20 years of age, is the age of development of emotions and sentiments. And this development of emotions and sentiments leads to the moral and social development. Development of moral and social qualities. So that was the stages as per the Rousseau. However, in the fifth part of the email, he also talks about the girl education. Here, there is a very interesting thing. Even though the Rousseau talks about the girl education. Okay, he talks about the girl education, that the girl should be educated. But he was only in opinion that women must be given a basic learning opportunity, that is the learning of reading and writing, learning of a basic skill of housekeeping, sewing, embroidery, weaving, and the religious education. He was in opinion that girl may be also engaged for singing and dancing. And there was a reason. As per the Rousseau thought, he was in opinion that men and women are not equal. That equality was not in the mind of Rousseau. He was in opinion that men are strong and positive, and they are active, whereas the women are weak and passive. So men are born to serve, whereas the women are born to please. That was the thought of the Rousseau as per the women education is concerned. So in the Rousseau philosophy, there is no much importance of the women education. You can understand that he has neglected the importance of a women education, and he has thought that men and women are not equal, and that's why the men should be educated to work, whereas the women must be educated to please and to do the household work, and for the better compatibility, they must be also given the basic literacy, that is the reading and writing. So that was the opinion of Rousseau for the women education. Even when we talk about the curriculum, we have seen that curriculum was very specific and stage specific. At a different stage, there was a different type of activities and a curriculum at that time, isn't it? Even when we talk about the Rousseau opinion about the methods of teaching, the method of a teaching was broadly included as experience and the observation method, learning by doing, playway method, heuristic method, and the life example for social and moral development. Life example, not a artificial one, authentic and a life example. One example that we have already quoted, that if the child is breaking the glass of a window, we should not punish, rather than we should allow the child to live in that room. So the child will learn the social and a moral behavior with the nature. He has given a prime importance of the learning by the nature. That's why the learning by doing, observation, experience, playway method, and heuristic is emphasized by the Rousseau. Here, it is again very important to mention that the teacher is not a primary, because the child is supposed to learn by their experience and observation and with the nature. So the role of a teacher is a secondary, not a primary, and the teacher is a guide in the educative process, and they have a limited role and a function. They must guide, they can motivate to exploit the inner tendency of the nature and the child, isn't it? But they will not impose any kind of hard rules. They will not punish. They will not reward. They will guide on. Isn't it? And when we talk about the discipline, in the opinion of Rousseau, the function of education is to foster natural development. And therefore, the Rousseau advocates that complete freedom with the minimum guidance. And he wants that the total absence of any kind of restriction on the part of children. There should be no place of reward and the punishment. Because the Rousseau was assuming that the child has no knowledge of a good and bad, but when they will suffer the pain by, and then they will learn by their mistake, and when they will have a pleasure of their act, then they will learn something right. So morality and a social behavior will be learned by the child themselves in the natural surrounding. And when we, the matter of a natural surrounding is coming, we can easily understand that the Rousseau was in opinion that there should be no rigid and a fixed structure of the school and the school organization. So there was no fixed structure, and he suggests that for the schooling purpose, the child must be separated from the parent. They must be taken away from the school, and they must be living in the natural environment so that they can learn by the environment. In the natural environment, child will himself look after the development of his natural abilities, and the child will be learning. That's why the location, the environment of the child should be away from the city, away from the human habitat, and it should be open to explore all the innate potential of the nature as well as the child.